It's not that easy to find an apartment that suits all your requirements in one step. Paradise Finder is that one stop for a user to find the best place he could live in. The application takes into account various aspects like location, ease of commute, etc., and provides a set of choices to choose from. This application goes one step forward and enables the user to make a refinement on the search by taking just the location preference from the user. Let's go ahead and check out the application. So when the user clicks login with LinkedIn, all he has to do is enter his email and password and enter allow access. And that's it. The app tells you the list of apartments based on the factors discussed before. The location is near Arizona State University, which we got from LinkedIn profile of Ganesh. Now let's assume Ganesh wants to search in a different location. All he has to do is type in the location in the text bar here, and the application gives all the details of the available apartments in that location. So let's say he wants to search for Oakland. Now the application enlists apartments that are in Oakland. It displays the address, square feet, number of bedrooms and bathrooms, year it was built, walk score, and comments on walk score. Walk score is measure of walkability of any address. The walkability is measurement of how friendly an area is. For each address, walk score analyzes hundreds of walking routes to nearby amenities. For example, if the walk score is between 90 to 100, it's walker's paradise. Between 70 to 89 would be very walkable. Bike score service measures whether a location is good for biking on a scale from 0 to 100. Transit score is a measure of how well a location is served by public transit. The application also gives a link to contact page. On clicking the link, it would display the contact page of that apartment. And lastly, there is a direction link which provides the location of that apartment in Google Maps.
Let us now look into the code structure in detail. First of all, the login is achieved using LinkedIn's OAuth API. After logging in, we get the user's basic profile information and store it in the user info session object. So when this page is getting loaded, so a JavaScript function named as validate is called in body onload. So in this JavaScript validate function, so we'll be calling a URL called as data/control along with the parameter named location. This URL is actually mapped to a servlet file called as datacontroller.java. So when this page is getting loaded, this URL is called and this servlet is getting invoked. When this servlet is getting invoked, we'll fetch the parameter named location and we'll check if the location is valid. If the location is not valid, then we'll fetch the LinkedIn's user information, and based on the LinkedIn's user info, we'll fetch the location. So once the location is obtained, we'll use Google Maps API to query the location, to query the zip code of the location by passing the location we obtained from the LinkedIn's user info. Then we'll pass the Google Maps API response and we'll fetch the zip code. Once the zip code is obtained, we'll pass the zip code to the load ontology's get apartment info method. Here, in this SparkQL query, we are fetching the apartment details like apartment address, latitude, longitude, etc. from the RDF file and filter the response with zip code. We use Apache FuseKey server for this purpose. Once we get a result set, we'll pass the result set to this function and we'll iterate one by one and fetch the apartment information like latitude, longitude, details like area, bathroom, bedroom, etc., address. And we load each and every parameter in a JSON file. And finally, we'll append all the JSONs into a JSON array, and then we'll return it. So once the list of JSON array has been written, we'll just print the JSON array in the response and return it. So in this dashboard.jsp, we'll look for details from the session object, which we'll be setting here. So if we get a valid details object, then we'll pass the details object and then we'll print the data in the screen. And for the refine search feature, we'll be getting the location information from the user input itself. So once we get the user location from the user input, the rest of the code flow remains the same. And that's the overview of our code structure. Thank you.